Hey guys, my name is Ismael Triviño and this is the Millennial Way Show. Our next guest is worldwide known for his role as Jaquen H'ghar in the Emmy Award winning HBO series Game of Thrones. One of the most mysterious characters of the series, mentor of Arya Stark and high priest of the House of Black and White. We talked with Tom Wlaschiha, the German actor who last year got naked as part of a global environmental campaign called End Overfishing, seeking to protect the oceans of our planet from overfishing. This happened during the world presentation of Game of Thrones, the touring exhibition in Barcelona. And we saved this interview for the premiere of the 8th and last season based on the saga of fantasy of George R.R. Martin's Song of Ice and Fire, where kings and queens, knights and renegades, imposters and nobles involved in a little game of chase in order to take control of the seven kingdoms of the West. Enjoy the interview. Tom, thank you very much for your time. How did you like the exhibition and how was your first impression?
It's great, it's really exciting. I walked through it yesterday and the first thing that I noticed is like it's in this great building of the Maritime Museum, which fits the mood of the show perfectly. And it's also like the lighting design and all the costumes and armors that you can see. It's all the little details that you might miss on screen because you focus on the actors when you watch the show. And here you have a chance to see everything up close and. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Can you tell our audience where are you right now and if that costume is your real one?
Yeah, this is actually my nightgown. we're in my office here, the House of Black and White, or at least a little part of it, because at the studios in Belfast, it was really big, but this gives a pretty good impression of what it looked like. And when I first read the scripts for season 5, I thought there's going to be a lot of green screen and post-production computer stuff, because I thought they can never build this huge hall. And then the first day I walked on set and they had actually really built it, and it was really amazing.
The Faceless Man of Braavos is one of the most mysterious characters on Game of Thrones. How did you build it? How did you create it?
I don't know. I mean, the most important thing for an actor is a script. And the scripts of Game of Thrones are incredibly well written, so the characters are all there. When I first read it, I thought, oh, he has this weird way of speaking, like a man does this, a man does that, always talking of himself in the third person. And I thought it could be a bit dangerous to get everything across, so I thought, yeah, maybe just to do it like with a very quiet and soothing voice so that actually people can understand me better. Yeah.
Tell us about the shooting process.
Well, you don't work every day. I mean, the shooting of a season is 4, 5, 6 months, and so you're not on set all the time. But it's a great experience because the costumes and the set design are so amazing that you actually, when you're in costume and you walk on the stage, you feel like you're in a different world, and it makes acting really easy because you automatically feel like you're in this, yeah, different time.
How do you feel to be part of a series that has broken all records? And how it has changed your life portraying Jaquen H'ghar in this HBO series?
It's been a real privilege to be part of the show. And my professional life has changed completely after Game of Thrones, because because the show is so successful and it's made me as an actor more known. And so I can only say this part has been a gift for me.
Tom, what's your favorite chapter or season in this series?
I really like them all. I like the second season. The character changes. This is what I like. After season two, when I first came on, I had a lot of comments from fans who were saying, no, you have to come back, because in the end I'm kind of changing my face into this other guy. And we like Jaquen, and you have to help Arya. And then after season five, things changed. Then I got a lot of comments saying, how dare you, I hate you, what did you do, why are you treating Arya so badly? I said, guys, it's not it's not my fault, it's what's in the script. And on top of that, she deserved it, you know? I mean, I wanted her to be the best assassin possible. I wanted her to give the best training, and she, for some reason, didn't listen to me.
Game of Thrones actually has turned also the most pirate series of the world. Is it true that even the characters this time didn't have the whole script on their hands as a preventive measure from HBO directives?
Well, I think that is a myth. I cannot imagine that. But yeah, obviously, because I mean, this piracy is really not a good thing and doesn't help any of us. So HBO and the producers have been really careful as not to give spoilers or to not leak any information, because I mean it's spoiling the fun for all of us who are watching it. And yeah.
In the fight of the Seven Kingdoms, where are you? In which side?
The Faceless Men, they're kind of above or a little away from everything. I mean, first of all, they're in Bravos. And then they have this philosophy that everybody's equal. You know, I mean, they will kill anyone. They will kill a king, they will kill a beggar if the price is right. So in that, they're very zen. Their only service is to their god, and they're saying that the ultimate gift that they can give is death, and that's true, and death gets to everyone regardless of their social status.
One of the characters that have changed the most in the series is Arya Stark. How was the experience working with Maisie Williams?
Yeah, I mean, Maisie's absolutely amazing. When I first met her, she was 12, and I couldn't believe how natural she was in front of a camera. I mean, obviously she didn't have any acting training or experience, and she was just pulling that stuff off, and it was amazing. And as the seasons went on, she had the chance to grow with her character, where in the beginning Arya is quite naive and gullible, then later on she becomes more scheming and plotting and more intelligent, conscious of the stuff that she's doing and pursuing. And I think she's been doing an amazing job.
When you finally saw the series on TV, how different did you find it from the shooting and post-production?
It wasn't that much different, because there weren't that many, as I said, there weren't that many special effects, at least in my scenes. And whenever we were on a set, everything was really built. It was really all there. I didn't have to imagine a lot of things. The only thing that I can think of was maybe the House of Black and White from the outside, which wasn't actually there. That's CGI. The only thing that was there was the door, the black and white door. We were shooting that in Croatia. And I pretty much had to walk in a door, and there was nothing behind it. But that was the only CGI thing. Everything else, the whole Hall of Faces was built.
Tom, thank you very much for your time. I really appreciate it.
Let's fight together now, or die.
To all the fans out there of Game of Thrones, we really hope you enjoyed this interview. It was a pleasure to have this guest, an amazing actor but also a champion in the environmental cause, raising his voice to create awareness about the overfishing that really is affecting our oceans, our planet. My name is Ismael Treviño, and this is the Millennial Way Show, empowering the new generations.